Okay, what the heck, Lego? You're uploading at 8 a.m. PST? Yeah, I have a very, very specific reason, and I will be transparent about what we're doing here. So when I saw this pop up on my Twitter feed, I just absolutely had to make a video about it. But this is the kind of thing that, depending on the events later today, might not even be worth discussing. So the time frame that we are able to make this video is so astronomically short. Secondly, I want to stay committed to why I want, so we're going to have that at 10 a.m. PST. Check it out, by the way. We're going to be talking about Logan Stankoven, and then have our other video at 12 p.m. PST. But the fact is, I really wanted to make this Habs video, and because there's a game that we're going to be streaming for at about 5-ish, 4-ish p.m. PST, I did not want to upload this video right before that game, because the time frame for this video's potential lifespan would significantly diminish if we uploaded it close to the game. The reason's pretty simple. When the real game is on, you're going to be watching that. Nobody's going to go onto YouTube and look for conversational commentary like this video is. So this video is being uploaded at 8 to put itself before all the stuff we have later on. Also to extend the potential lifespan of this video if things later today were to go south. So thank you to those in the previous Habs video who commented Marty McSorley. If you want a chance to be featured in the next one, then stick around to the end here. I wanted to give a very big shout out to a user on Twitter who indeed follows me. I didn't realize this until I saw this post pop up on my timeline, Caulfield Habs 2. His display name is Dino for the Selkie, and he posted this image that I wanted to read out over here. It's a comparison between Montreal in 1993 and Montreal in 2021. He highlights it and he says, "This is absolutely nuts." So what we're going to be doing in this video is going over each of the individual points and talking about just how eerily similar the 2021 run has been to the 1993 run. And of course, you know why the 93 run is important. I'm not going to say anything to that respect. So, firstly, in 1993, in the Montreal Canadiens Stanley Cup playoff run, they were down 2-1 in the first round to a rival squad. They came back to win. Interestingly enough, the Montreal Canadiens of this year, 2021, did that too. In 1993, the Canadiens suffered this fate to the Quebec Nordiques. They were actually down 2-0 in the series after dropping Game 1 3-2 in overtime and then dropping Game 2 4-1. They eventually won Game Number 3 2-1 in overtime with, guess who, Vincent Damphousse getting the overtime winner, lessening the Nordiques' lead to a score of 2-1. For Montreal in 2021, they were up 1-0 in the series because Anderson and Byron in Game 1 against Toronto did that. But then they lost two more, putting them down 2-1. It's not a direct comparison because the Habs in 93 were down 2-0, whereas the Habs in 21 were down 3-1, so it's not necessarily the same. But let's go ahead a little bit further and talk about some more similarities here. The Habs in 93, after defeating the Nordiques 4-2, they won 4 straight after being down 2-0 in that series, they defeated the Buffalo Sabres 4-0 with a sweep. In fact, it's kind of crazy because 3 of the 4 games were in overtime. You had yourselves all 4-3 Montreal wins in that series. You had Guy Carboneau, Gilbert Dion, as well as Kirk Muller scoring the overtime winners there, taking the series 4-0. Guess what? The Habs in 2021 also swept their second-round opponents, the Winnipeg Jets. That's a lot more recent in the minds of many Habs fans watching today, but if you need a refresher, Mark Scheifele did the thing, Mark Scheifele was taken out, the Jets were not really themselves afterwards, the Canadiens just kind of found ways to win, get it done, low-scoring games, high-scoring games, hey, they were able to do it, and they swept the Jets in round 2. The next point on this little image here, they then meet a West Coast team after sweeping their second-round opponent. Now, the order is a little bit off here because the 93 Habs met the LA Kings in the Stanley Cup Finals. The 2021 Habs are meeting the Golden Knights in the third round. But the similarities in these West Coast matchups are quite daunting. Because in Game 1 against their Western Coast team, both the 93 Habs and the 2021 Habs lost 4-1. Yeah, that's right. Against LA in 93, it was a 4-1 loss. Against Vegas in 21, it was a 4-1 loss. What happens afterwards, though? Hey, Game 2 against their Western Conference team. The Habs win 3-2. Against LA, it was a 3-2 overtime win, and you all know the story about this one, but hey, just in case you hadn't seen it yet, The Habs were losing this one. They were down 2-1, and at the end of the third period, that's when things got crazy, because according to Habs head coach Jacques Demers, hey, Guy Carboneau, the captain of the squad, he let him know, I think that guy, Marty McSorley, is using an illegal stick. And sure enough, he challenged it, called the refs over, they did a measurement of the stick, it was deemed illegal, there was a penalty, the Habs then scored, it was Eric Desjardins who had already scored earlier in the game, then he scored a minute into overtime, giving the Habs the 3-2 win in Game 2. It's kind of crazy how Desjardins had a hat trick then, isn't it? In fact, he's the only D-man to ever get a hat trick in the Stanley Cup Finals, because that was in the Finals when the Habs played LA in 93. But in 2021, Game 2 against Vegas is also a 3-2 win. They get a 3-0 lead, Petrangelo almost gets it back, but ultimately Carey Price hangs on a 3-2 win in Vegas. So, yeah, nice. You also had yourselves the third game of the series where both Habs teams in 93 and 21 defeated their opposition in overtime. In 1993, guess who it was? It was John LeClair. Yeah, he's a pretty good Philadelphia Flyers guy, but he was also there with the Habs in 93, scoring in overtime, giving his team the 4-3 overtime victory. Game 3 against Vegas this year was also in overtime, and it was one of the worst officiated games in NHL history, not to mention just the overall vindication you felt after Josh Anderson buried his second of the game. So a lot of similarities so far between 93 and 21. And sure, it's really easy to just pick stats and individual stories that somewhat align and say, look, it's so similar to what we have from before and now. So I'm not going to make this video to guarantee anything happening in the future, but I mean, just having the similarities right here, it's laid out in front of you. It's kind of funny how 93 and 21 align. So also, the Habs swept a team in the second round in both years that had previously swept their first round opponents. In 1993, the Buffalo Sabres squad that the Canadiens ended up defeating, they swept the Boston Bruins in round one. Meanwhile, the 2021 Winnipeg Jets that the Habs swept had swept the Edmonton Oilers in the first round as well. That's really strange right there, that parallel. You also had a really good overtime run, and I say really good, not undefeated. It says here in the tweet undefeated because that's not actually what happened in 93. Sure, the Habs did win 10 straight overtime periods in 1993, but they did not actually start off hot. They lost the very first overtime they played in the 1993 playoff run. It was Game 1 against Quebec, so yeah. And then you also had the overtime winners in Game 3 of the series against Vegas and LA, so the two Western Conference teams, being scored by number 17. That was John LeClair in 93 against LA, that was Josh Anderson in 2021 against Vegas. Awesome to see the parallels right there with the numbers. And I'm actually missing one more parallel that was displayed in the image right here. I saved it for the very end because of course I did. You had the goalie winking at a player. In 2021, it's Carey Price. Mark Stone comes in on a beautiful rush opportunity. He gets stoned by the glove of Price. And Carey Price afterwards, hey, he's looking to his own teammate and he gives out a little wink. You don't have to worry about me, buddy. Whatever comes my way, I'm gonna do my best to stop it. Now, it's different from when Patrick Waugh did his iconic wink in 1993. That moment happened in Game 4, where Thomas Sandstrom, an LA Kings star at the time, had the puck in front. He tried to wrap it in on the open side, but Patrick Waugh covered it up with a glove. He said no, and as Sandstrom was skating by Waugh, he received a nice warm smile from the Canadiens netminder and a very complimentary wink to go with it. So it's not the same. Waugh's winking at an opponent, Price is winking at his own teammate, so not exactly the same, but hey, still a very similar parallel right there. And that kind of about does it for this video topic over here, going over some weird similarities between Montreal in 93 and Montreal in 2021. Again, this doesn't guarantee anything, it's not even really anything to write home about, but it's a fun conversation to have, which is why we made this at 8 a.m. PST. So hey, check out this channel before the game starts. We're going to be streaming for the game as always, have ourselves a conversation about what's going on, and have a fun time watching the game as well. But for now, if you made it to the end of this video, then comment in the comment section below, Brian Bellows, for no particular reason at all. Talk to me in the comments what you thought about this video, the conversation we had, the similarities between 93 and 2021. I hope you enjoyed this video, so that's Trolls99. And bye.